welcome to read, rant, and review. Today we are going to look at a book about vampires, a request by one of our faithful viewers.
Okay, so I'm not a very convincing vampire, and it's not even evening. That's better. The book we're going to look at today is called Bloodsucking Fiends, and it's by Christopher Moore, who I'm relatively certain is like a popular guy. I really don't know. You know, for a book reviewer, I'm not really up on who's popular or famous right now. Oh well. So let's read the back. Waking up under an overturned dumpster, Jody has a creepy feeling that something strange happened to her after she was attacked in a San Francisco alley. Now she's seeing weird auras around people, and the smell of blood is simply too sweet to resist. Yep, she's a vampire. Realizing she can't live a normal life anymore, she searches for a minion, or at least someone to run errands for her during daytime. Enter wide-eyed C. Thomas Flood. Fresh off the bus from Indiana, Tommy hits it off with Jody, but soon dark forces begin to play games with them. Blood-sucking fiends will have readers howling with laughter as Jody and Tommy battle a serial-killing vampire. So I should start this off by saying that I am not really a fan of vampire books. Vampires don't interest me. I'm not sure why they never have. You know, my love of zombies, you know of, but my just boredom at vampires. I mean, I enjoy Buffy the Vampire Slayer, but that's not for the vampires. That's mostly for the other characters, and the vampires are just also there. So I'm starting off in a place of not really being interested in the subject matter, so I'm sorry if that colors my opinion of the book. So here's the deal. I normally review two kinds of books. Books that I really, really love, or books that I really, really hate. Because if I just review every book that I read and every book that I just kind of feel, it was okay, it was a mildly interesting book, it'd be a really boring review. So I try to only review a book when I have a strong emotion about it. And unfortunately, I don't have a strong emotion about Bloodsucking Fiends. I found it to be enjoyable, but I wouldn't reread it. I didn't hate anything about it necessarily. It was meh. It was a meh book to me. I apologize for anybody who was really hoping to see me tear this apart or whatever. But let's talk about it because someone did request it, so here we go. Boy, we're off to a good start. The characters were okay. They were entertaining. I didn't dislike them. I didn't feel myself being particularly drawn to them either. I mean, I liked that Jody is a female vampire, and she's not the stereotypical female vampire that we usually see. She just is an average person trying to deal with the fact that now she's a vampire, and that's pretty enjoyable, and she is a woman and a vampire without being a stereotype in either of those cases. I mean, she is a little bit concerned about clothes and her weight, but it's never like in your face like, oh man, women's, they're so into clothes and dieting, am I right? And the male character was okay. He was like a country bumpkin guy who didn't understand city things, and he was nice. I liked him. I have no strong feelings about this book. It's bad. I better conjure up some strong feelings soon. I liked the Emperor character. He's cool. He shows up in the very beginning of the book, so I don't think it's too much of a spoiler for me to tell you about him. He is a bum, kind of, who thinks he's like the emperor of the city, and he's got two dogs that go around with him that are his men. And he's entertaining. I think he was probably my favorite character. Again, I don't feel super strong about it, but he was alright. I do hope, however, because this book is a series, because every fucking book is part of a series now, see my rant about that, because this book is part of a series, I do hope that the Emperor is in more, and we find out more about him, because he is a little smidge confusing at times, and so I hope that he keeps coming back, and we find out more about where he came from and what's up with him. Something I kind of found interesting in this book, and it's just a little tidbit that I noticed, Tommy goes to work in a grocery store, and the crew that he works with are this sort of eclectic group of guys that call themselves, or other people call them, the animals. And then some of the only real animals in the book are referred to as men. So it kind of confused my brain a little bit at times, because it'd be like the animals, and I would think they were talking about the two dogs. But the two dogs are the men, and the group of dudes is the animals. And I think that was an intentional contrast. Just, I don't know what you do with it, I'm just pointing it out. However, I could not keep the animals straight. They were all given sort of personalities, I guess, but I couldn't remember who was who at any given time. There were a couple of, like, smaller subplots within this book that seemed just a smidge aimless. Maybe they're going to come to fruition in later books. I don't really know. Especially, like, some of the subplots weren't necessarily aimless so much as, to me, just not necessary. They felt a little bit like padding, and you know how I feel about padding. But honestly, that's kind of a nitpick. I'm trying really hard to have a strong emotion about this book, so there was padding. Naughty, naughty book. One thing I kind of did like that this book did is there were sex scenes, but they didn't annoy me as much as sex scenes normally do. And that is because none of these sex scenes felt gratuitous. None of them felt like they were there to titillate. I hate it when I'm reading a book and suddenly it feels like it just turned into porn. Like, even though these sex scenes were kind of intense and unusual because, hey, there's a vampire involved, I was never sitting there rolling my eyes going, oh my gosh, I'm suddenly reading porn, make it stop. I also liked the ending to this book. It kept me guessing to some extent, and it was fun. It was really fun and really adventurous. And, like, through most of the book, maybe could be considered a little bit slow, but the ending is definitely worth the trip. It's worth it because it's a really fun and peppy ending. The writing style in this book was very snappy and very witty, and at times that annoyed me. It felt like it was trying too hard. Like, it felt like it was sloppy in that way. And I know I'm probably picking on an author who is, like, famous for this style or something. But, you know, like, Terry Pratchett has a very specific way of writing that is super snappy and super witty, but he never makes you feel like it's like a gimmick. The writing style in this one, it kept taking me out. I couldn't quite shake how kind of like, look at me, I can write really snappy, witty way, woo, look at that. Kind of the author just trying to be like Terry Pratchett or like other authors that write that way. And I'm probably like way off base and everybody's going, oh my gosh, no, that's Christopher Moore's style, how dare you insult it. But to me it felt gimmicky and it didn't suit the story all the time. Many authors, including myself, strive to write concisely. Don't use four words when one word will do, and it felt like he was using four words when one word would have worked. And yeah, I didn't like it. So yeah, I guess that's everything that I can think of. Again, I just kind of felt meh about this book. It wasn't a chore, but it's not necessarily something I would read on my own. It did not make me want to go check out the series, even though I am curious about, you know, what happens with the Emperor. I'm not motivated enough to go read any more books in the series, and it also did not spark any desire to read other vampire books in me. I just don't like vampires, you guys. They're just kind of boring. Well, anyway, I'll see you later. Guess I gotta go, like, suck some blood or something. I don't know. What do I do when I'm not reviewing books? I don't even know.